After I read The Palace of Illusions last year, Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni quickly became one of my favorite authors of all time. Imagine my excitement when this book came out. Like, I had to have it and I had to read it. And I got it and I read it. And now I want to share my thoughts about this book with you, because otherwise it would feel like I'm not doing justice to one of my favorite authors of all time. Hey guys, this is Sonali, the Melodramatic Bookworm. Welcome back to my channel. Growing up, the Ramayana was one of my favorite books to read, even if you included the Enid Blytons, the Tinkles and Goosebumps, which I absolutely loved. And even though over time I've come to, you know, understand different perspectives, it will always be that one book that will give me nostalgia to, you know, childhood lessons in morality. And the point remains that however much we want to think that women actually had a big hand in our epics, in how our epics panned out, the truth is that they were always treated as the lesser human beings. The Ramayana focuses on the life of Lord Ram and the righteousness that was within him and blanketed the people around him, and the harsh steps that he took along with the reasons that they gave. But we didn't hear much about the women in the epic and their thoughts about whatever Ram said or did. The Forest of Enchantments rectifies this and tells us the Ramayana from Sita's perspective as she saw it. Sita was considered a goddess herself, and this book shows how Sita was almost always at the receiving end of all the righteous decisions that Ram took. Yes, she did make three of the biggest bad decisions that set the Ramayana on the path that it took, but the consequences were almost too extreme at every single point. Maybe it was a result of the times that they lived in, but in this time and age, when we read things in a different way, it reeks of injustice. The Forest of Enchantments tells us about Sita's thoughts, yes, obviously, but we also learn about what the other women in the Ramayana actually thought of everything that transpired. The first thought that went through my mind when I started reading The Forest of Enchantments, and I was only about 4 or 5 pages in, is that I want to write down everything. Like, every quote is, I found amazing at that point in time. And for this one, I found the narrative to be appropriately enjoyable and appropriately emotional in the places that it was required to be. Or at least I'll say in most places that it was required to be. The biggest thing about The Forest of Enchantments is that it builds on the premise that Sita might be Ravan's daughter, just like Anand Nilakandan's book Asura. But while Asura's world building was a bit more sympathetic towards Ravan and showed him to be kind and benevolent to everyone, The Forest of Enchantments more or less uses Ravan's kindness, shows it in a very realistic way, without flipping the epic that we know on its head. I feel like this is a facet that I must talk about when I talk about this book. And because our mythology has, you know, drawn a particular picture of characters like Ravan, this means that however much they might have done to, you know, further the cause of the kingdom, it makes it almost impossible for us to imagine them as anything but vile power. Cruel and power-hungry creatures. And when books like The Forest of Enchantments come, we embrace them with everything we have because they build on the character's negativity. There are two more lessons that this book stresses upon. One, that misogyny is and will be a huge part of our myths or epics. And two, that there are different shades of love, and these explanations are scattered across the book and it's quite interesting to read. A couple of points though. First, I was surprised, shocked even, that in quite a few places the writing seemed like it was from a moderately bad review copy. And I was so heartbroken because this was not the Chitra Banerjee style that I fell in love with. Plus, if I'm not mistaken, the Ramayana did not end like this, but I'm ready to ignore this one because it's a retelling. Though I usually love Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni's writing, there was quite a few points in this book that made me hold back and not give it a full 5 and instead give it a 3.75 out of 5 stars. And this is something that I didn't think would ever happen. So what did you think of my review? Did you like it? Did you not like it? Did you read this book? Will you read this book? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. And if you'd like to go ahead and buy this book after watching my review, please use the Amazon affiliate links in the description box below. I get a small cut off of every purchase that you make while the price remains the same for you. If you like this video, you know what to do. Please like, share, subscribe and click on the bell icon beside the subscribe button to get notified as and when I post new videos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Until next time, keep reading, keep watching and add melodrama to your life.